Mic check, mic check. What's kicking, family? I'm glad you've clicked in so I can check in with you. All right. First and foremost, Happy New Year to everybody out here. As you can tell in the background, got a little bit more snow here in New York. Love it, man. I just love this kind of weather. All right. Now, let's close out 2009 with the last week of pro football picks for week 17. Might as well close out the right way. You guys have all seen the all playoff scenarios. You know, this one's got to lose, this one's got to win, this one's got to lose, this one's got to win. I'm not even going to go through it because it'll even confuse me from time to time. So let's get down with the weekly picks. All right, for week 17. And let's start rocking and rolling. Colts at the Bills. Colts took some heat for pulling Peyton Manning early in the game against the Jets. Bill Polian had to stop his show 15 minutes to go. Next thing you know, they had another station take over. The fans is upset, irate. Rex Ryan was taking credit for the win. Yeah, we won. You know, in the paper says, yeah, we won. And Bill Polian saying, no, we pulled out. Hey, this is the bottom line. The Jets got the win, and if they win this week, they're in. But we'll get to that one later on. And let's finish up here, Colts at the Bills. All right, Colts, I wanted to see history. I wanted to see perfection. I was listening to Sports Talk Radio the other day, and the Sports Talk host had brought something up, which each and every one of you know once I said it. You cannot go undefeated in baseball, hockey, basketball. That's right. The only sport you can go undefeated and get the whole ball of wax, the whole shebang, the whole kit and caboodle is football. And I would have loved to have seen the Colts try and attain that kind of level of legendariness. Is that a word? But in any event, they didn't do it. All right. Let's move on. Colts at the Bills. I got the Bills. Saints at the Panthers. Wow, what a contest here. The Saints have been on a fall recently. You don't need to be like that going into the postseason. The Panthers are coming off of beating up two of the bigger names in the league. Can they keep that flowing to close out their season on a winning note? The Saints need to get on track and to get a good win so that they can feel good going into the playoffs. I got the Saints. Jaguars at the Browns. Well, for the Browns, a lot of guys are playing for their job. Eric Mangini's status is undecided at this time. And as you know, Mike Holmgren is in the house. That's right. He had bought a house in the area. And whenever a coach or somebody like that is buying a house in the prospective area of the team where they're supposed to be going to play, they're going there. Jaguars at the Browns. I got the Browns. Eagles at the Cowboys. Now, you guys know all the playoff scenarios dealing with this game. This is a big NFC East contest. Let me spit that out right. A little bit cold out here. Got to get the jaws working. I'm not going to show you the flask that I have for this kind of weather. Maybe on another show, but hey. Back to the Eagles at the Cowboys. Big contest in the NFC East between these two teams. I'm going to go with the Cowboys on this one. Right, they seem to have kind of like solved their December swoon. So we'll see how that plays out for the Cowboys. And they win this, they'll keep Wade Phillips around a little bit longer. Also, I had seen a blurb, a news report someplace along the line, where Andy Reid had said that Donovan McNabb and Tony Romo seem to be better quarterbacks with T.O. gone. Ooh, okay. Eagles at the Cowboys, they got the Cowboys. Bears at the Lions. I got the Bears at the Lions. They're going to win one for Lovie Smith. He's out the door. Patriots at the Texans. Okay, I like the Texans to shake things up here. All right. Steelers at the Dolphins. The Steelers, man, how the mighty have fallen from grace. The former, well, they are the defending Super Bowl champions, and we don't know where the hell they're going to end up in this playoff scenario. I'm not even going to bother to go through it. I like to see how they, just let's see where the chips fall where they may. Steelers at Dolphins, I got the Steelers. Giants at the Vikings. Giants, no Brandon Jacobs. A massive set of injuries. I mean, you know, they need this win to go out on a good note. The Vikings need this win to keep a higher seeding in the NFC. It's going to be a pretty good contest. A lot of these games you probably figured would be rollover games, people who have nothing to play for. But when it comes down to it, you're going to see a few games with some great effort. All right, Giants at the Vikings. That's right. I got Big Blue. All right. Bengals at the Jets. Now, let's, Jets. Bengals. They'll see what happens by the time their game comes because it's been moved on the flex schedule. They got the 8 o'clock joint. So they'll be able to find out what everybody else is doing by the time they get to that game. But I see the Jets taking out the Bengals. And Ocho Cinco has claimed that Darrell Revis could not check him on a street corner in a phone booth in Manhattan. Yo, that kid, I like him, man. He talks some very engaging smack. And the thing about it, man, when you're able to do that, talk the smack and whatnot, and you can back it up, man, you got props, baby. But Bengals at the Jets in the night game on Sunday night, I got the Jets. 49ers at the Rams. Rams. 49ers. Whew. I thought the 49ers would be a lot better than what their record indicates at this point, and I feel that the 49ers need this win in order to maintain a nice, you know, going into the offseason on an up note. You need to build on something positive, and I think Singletary's done a good job with them. 49ers at the Rams, I got the 49ers. Falcons at the Buccaneers. I got the Falcons over the Bucks, but the Falcons better look out because the Buccaneers shocked the world last week. And you got to watch out for these teams that are on the bottom. They have nothing to play for but, you know, pride. Rondé Barber had, I seen a blurb, some rumor on a report, a quote attributed to Rondé Barber, that he would retire if Raheem Morris is released. Woo, man, already they're going to release Raheem Morris? Give him a minute, man. Let him work on some stuff there. All right, Falcons at the Buccaneers. I got the Falcons. Packers at the Cardinals. Cardinals ain't got too much to play for. They're just about going to sit back, chill, and chill out. And it's going to be the Packers. The Packers are going to need this game. They're going to play in order to, you know, maintain that seeding. You know what's the bug out, though, y'all? I wouldn't be surprised if when everything shakes out, the Packers and the Vikings meet. That would be oh, wow. I don't know how it's going to go, but we'll see. All right. Excuse me. All right, where did I leave off at? Packers at the Cardinals, I got the Packers. Chiefs at the Broncos. Broncos, man, y'all was exposed, man. After ripping off all them games and then coming down and then dropping some contests like that, and then the Chiefs is up here rolling around. Oh, man, I got the Broncos. Yeah, I got the Broncos to make it interesting out there against them and the Chargers. You know what I'm saying? All right, then. Ravens at the Raiders. Oh, snap. Ray Ray and crew. Ray Rice. The kid has been doing his thing on the ground over there for the Ravens. But, hey, I've been drinking the Kool-Aid. I'm going with the Raiders. I don't know why. I just picked them. I just figured I'd pick them. Redskins at the Chargers. Sorry, Redskins. That's pretty – yo, that is a sad franchise when there's an interview for the head coach's job and they interviewed somebody from his staff. I got the Chargers, man. I feel sorry for the Redskins. That was one of those proud franchises, one of the older franchises in the league, which was competitive and up there. But, hey, I don't know what Daniel Snyder's doing, man. He needs intervention. He needs somebody to come in there. Well, that's why he brought in my man Allen, the son of the former head coach of the Redskins from in the day. So he wants to return to glory. I got the Chargers. And the last game that I have here is the Titans at the Seahawks. Yo, Seahawks, what happened? Matt Hasselbeck should have took the whole year off in injured reserve. The Titans had a chance to really they could have had a chance to really make some inroads and really shake up that playoff tree type deal. I got the Titans. So this is Mr. Batch. We're going to close out 2009. I hope you have a healthy and healthy, a happy and healthy one. And we want to, you know, say and give our condolences because we lost two people in the football world this year. We lost McNair and Henry. You know, our condolences to their family and stay strong. And other than that, man, hey, 34 bowl games, and there's a bunch of games on Christmas Eve going into Christmas Eve. Did I say Christmas Eve? I bet there's a bunch of bowl games on New Year's Eve going into New Year's Day, and I hope each and every one of you, at least you football fans, enjoy the games. This is Mr. Batch. Stay blessed. I'm out. Peace.